Hello, I'm Nick Weig, a father, husband, journalist, and recipient of a life-saving kidney transplant. If you're watching this, you're considering a pancreas transplant to eliminate the need for insulin and secure a better quality of life. There are three ways to get a pancreas transplant: simultaneously with a kidney transplant, a pancreas transplant after a kidney transplant, or a pancreas transplant alone. Our team will discuss these options with you and determine which is most appropriate for your condition. There are always risks with a pancreas transplant, but also many potential benefits, including a less restrictive diet and long-term improvement in blood flow to vital organs. A successful pancreas transplant can often eliminate the need for insulin. It may also improve potential organ damage complications from diabetes. Often, it can be part of a solution for kidney failure for patients with diabetes. A pancreas can often be donated from the same donor as your kidney. Now that you know the benefits and risks, you might be wondering what makes a patient eligible for a pancreas transplant. Well, if you have type 1 diabetes, there are a few criteria you must meet. You must have renal failure, be below a certain BMI, have some end organ damage from diabetes, and not on too much insulin. Patients who have trouble determining if their blood sugars are low and have negative effects from that may also be eligible. Also, a potential candidate, people with type 2 diabetes. The transplant team will also look at your heart and blood vessels to make sure you do not have disease significant enough to limit your ability to get a pancreas. Your time on the pancreas transplant waitlist could be similar to the kidney waitlist, but will depend on a variety of factors, including your blood type, antibody level, and other factors. Differing from a kidney transplant, a simultaneous kidney pancreas transplant is done through a long incision in the middle of your abdomen. During the surgery, the new pancreas will be put on the right side. If this surgery is done at the same time as your kidney, both organs will be transplanted through the same incision. Your original pancreas will not be removed. The kidney is placed on the left side. After surgery, you will recover in the intensive care unit for 1 to 2 days. Then you will go to the transplant inpatient unit to recover. When you wake up after surgery, you'll find a urinary catheter is now in place, along with a drain on your side to help remove extra fluids. At first, you will start by consuming only clear liquids, but in a short time, you will progress to a normal diet. You will also be expected to walk early on in the recovery process and use tools to help you expand your lungs to prevent complications from surgery. Often, patients will stay at the hospital for 6 to 10 days. Now, I know this can be a lot to take in. Please be assured that you are in the right place. The transplant program's results often exceed the national averages each year, and I know I felt safe putting my life in their hands. You can find specific information by looking at the national reporting resources.